This is JB from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time we are continuing our run through the Rise of Red Skull campaign with Spider-Woman, and we are up against Taskmaster on standard difficulty. So last time we managed to beat Crossbones after a couple of tries, and also Absorbing Man on our first try, and this time we are playing against Taskmaster, and after I manage to beat Taskmaster, I'll fight against Zola in the later part of this video, and after this video we will finish off this series by fighting Red Skull himself. But let's see the scenario. We are playing Taskmaster on standard difficulty, so we are starting at the Taskmaster phase 1. During the setup we put the Hydra Patrol into play and added one threat to the main scheme, hunting down heroes. So the theme of this scenario is that we will get side schemes that will put one of these captive heroes for hire into play, so these are randomized and we might get them to help us. So more on that when we get those side schemes in play. I also upgraded Spider-Woman with the basic attack upgrade, so we have a permanent which gives us plus one hit point and plus one attack, so we have a base attack of two with Spider-Woman. But I think that's enough of the deck and scenario. Well, I'll just mention that we are playing with the pre-built deck that comes in the Rise of Red Skull box, so I haven't made any changes to the deck. And other than that, let's see how we can deal with Taskmaster and the Hydra minions he has, so let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand of 6 cards. So we get the attack team, self-propelled glide, Captain Marvel, skilled investigator, rest the advantage and strength. I think we don't have resources to play the attack team just yet. I think we will play Captain Marvel. Just thinking. I think I'll use those cards to play Captain Marvel. Then we can still play skilled investigator. And I only mulligan that one card, so let's see. We get Inconspicuous. I think we actually play Inconspicuous. I think I think we can't remove threat from here because we have this scheme in play which prevents it. So yeah, let's just start playing and see how it goes. So let's just check the top card of the deck. So we have a photography free plexus attachment attached to Taskmaster. Okay, but it's going to be a boost card, so that's okay. Let's flip to Spider-Woman. We'll play Captain Marvel. I'll use strength. Inconspicuous. And press the advantage. So then I'll play the skilled investigator. So I gain one boost to Spider Woman's traits. Let's see here. So I think Captain Marvel will twerk for two. We remove that side scheme, and now we can trigger skilled investigator. We draw a card. We get piercing strike. Then, when defeated, each player searches their counter deck and discard pile for a Hydra minion and puts it in play. Engage with them. Shuffle the encounter deck. So let's search for a Hydra minion. I think we'll just take a Hydra regular, because it's easy to defeat the Spider-Woman. Okay, well, now we shuffled the deck, so we don't know what the top card is anymore. So Hydra regular comes into play, has inside one, so we add one bet here. Then Spider-Woman will attack and defeat it. Then we will play self-propelled glide to ready, and we'll attack, and we have an attack of 3 with the basic attack upgrade and getting one boost by playing one aspect card, so we deal 3 damage. And what I forgot is that after a player changes to hero form, they discard the top card of the encounter deck and take damage equal to the number of boost icons. So I'll just search for the card that I revealed, because it was, yeah, new scenario, so making some mistakes. Well, it is what it is. So we had this card at the top of the deck, so we got 2 boost icons when we discarded it. So now we'll deal 2 damage to Spider-Woman from the forced response on Taskmaster. And yeah, so we did 3 damage to Taskmaster. That's our turn. And let's not forget about the consequent damage on Captain Marvel. Let's ready up. We draw back up to 5. Get our self-propelled glide. Clear the area. Inconspicuous. Clear the area. Interrogation room. So a lot of thwarting power for next turn. Hopefully we have some targets for those cards. Let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat to the main scheme. Taskmaster attacks. I'll just take it with Spider-Woman. Oh yeah, and after resolving the step 1 of the villain phase, each player in hero form must choose to either place one threat here or take one damage. I'll place the threat because we have a lot of cards to remove threat. So Taskmaster hits for 2 plus 1, so we take 3 damage. And the encounter card is Uncertain Loyalties. You may flip to Alter Ego form, choose Exhaust Jessica Drew, remove Uncertain Loyalties from the game. Place 3 threat on the main scheme, discard this obligation. I think I have enough power to remove the threat, so we'll just discard this and add 3 threat here. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. So let's see. We have no minions, so the interrogation room is quite useless, but I think I'll play Inconspicuous. We remove 3 threat from any schemes in play. Then we will play Clear the Area. Again, we remove 2 And I think I'll just keep the self-propelled glide for next turn. We will attack with, or we could play it, let's just attack with Captain Marvel. So we hit for 2 damage. And we draw a card. And we will hit for 3 damage. We'll ready by self-propelled glide. And we hit for 3 damage. So we are pounding on the Taskmaster. Hopefully getting him down before all hell breaks loose. So we draw back up to 5 after we ready up. We get finesse, combat training, Spider-Man, Jessica Drew's apartment, and contaminant immunity. And we go to the villain phase. We add 1 threat plus 1 threat from the forced effect. Taskmaster will attack, Captain Marvel will defend. We get 3 damage, which will defeat Captain Marvel. Counter card for this turn is advance, so Taskmaster schemes for 1 plus 3, so 4. That's quite a lot. We are at 8 of 12, so I think we need to try thwarting next turn. Okay, unfortunately we don't have enough to play Spider-Man, which is a shame, but it is what it is. So that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see what we can do. So I think we have to forego playing Spider-Man. We don't have enough cards. So I'll use Spider-Man and Jessica Drew's apartment to play finesse. I'll use finesse and combat training to play contaminant immunity. And this is what I messed up in the last couple of games. So these are also aspect cards, even if they are not part of the aspects used to build Spider-Woman. They are still counted as both Spider-Woman cards and protection cards, so they count as aspect cards, so I get the boost. Okay, so I'll heal 3 damage and gain the tough status. And then I think I have to thwart for 2. Just to keep threat in check. And that is our turn. We ready up. So we get clear the area. Another bonus. Piercing strike. Skilled investigator and venom blast. So next turn we can remove a bit more threat than this turn. The villain phase starts. We add 1 threat here. And we'll have to add another here, so we don't lose tough. Taskmaster attacks, I won't defend, so we get 4 damage, but we only lose the tough. And luckily we missed the shadows of the past. We'll get then a counter card. It is Hydra regular, so we add 1 threat here. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. I'll play the I'll play the finesse with piercing strike and under skilled investigator. I'll hold on to this one. So I'll play clear the area and remove 2 threat. And I'll just defeat the Hydra regular. So we keep this in hand for next turn. Let's draw back up to 5. Okay, so we get pheromones, so that's helpful. We can slow down the villain quite a lot with that. So we have a skilled investigator, press the advantage, pheromones, heroic intuition, venom blast. So that's okay. We go to villain phase, we add one threat here. And now I'll take the one damage because we don't have tough to lose. Taskmaster attacks. This time, well, I won't defend. I'll take 2 plus 2, so 4 damage. Just remove these. Encounter card is Weapon Master. The villain attacks you if they have a weapon attachment, this can search, so now I'll defend. 2 plus 1 is 3, so 1 damage. And that's the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. This turn I'll play pheromones. So we'll get one here, and Taskmaster is stunned and confused. Then I'll use the skilled investigator and Venom Blast to play Heroic Intuition. So we go to 2 bonus. It doesn't really matter, but I think I'll flip because Taskmaster is not scheming on this turn. We'll keep the press the advantage, and we draw back up to 6. Well, let's see what's this card. So it's an assault, so it gains search, so that's fine. Okay, so let's draw back up to 6. So we get press the advantage times 2, combat training, pheromones, spider girl, and interrogation room. And we ready up. So we add one threat here. We are not in hero form, so we don't have to do the other forced ability. Taskmaster tries to scheme, but is confused. Encounter card is the assault, so it searches. And we get the Hydra soldier. And that's the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. Okay. Let's check the top card from here. So we are getting captured by Hydra, which will bring us one of these heroes for hire into play. So I think we'll just heal. So we heal 3, we flip. I'll play Spider Girl. Spider Girl will confuse and stun the Hydra soldier. And then we'll gain one here. I think I'll play the interrogation room. And I'll play the combat training. So we have quite a lot of, I think I'll put these boost cards here, so easier to see. Okay, that's our turn, we ready up. Go back up to 5. Oh yeah, and we took 1 damage for flipping into hero mode. Oh yeah, it's determined by this, so... Okay, we took 2 damage. I keep forgetting the interaction with these, those cards. That's okay. We get contaminant immunity, genius, tech team, venom blast, and energy, so will be an explosive turn next turn. We add 1 threat here. We are at 10. So I think I'll take the 1 damage. Hold on. And Taskmaster tries to attack is stunned. Hydro Soldier tries to attack is stunned. Encounter card is combat knife. Attached to villain plus 1 attack. Attached villain attacks gains piercing, so they go through tough. Okay. And that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, I think we will, we lose those. I think we will just, we are attack of 3 now, so we'll just play contaminant immunity. We heal 3. We also gain top. We will just attack Hydra Soldier. We have 4, because we played 1 aspect card. And I think... Yeah, we'll remove 1 threat from the main scheme. See, I think I will use these 2, and actually 1 of these, and yeah. So we'll play tag team, and I think we'll trigger tag team. We'll hit for 2. We go to phase 2 of Taskmaster. So Taskmaster is scheme 2, attack 2. When revealed, deal each player an encounter card. And again, after player changes to hero form, they discard the top card of their encounter deck and take damage equal to the number of boost icons on that card. And Taskmaster has 16 health. And Spider Girl will hit for 2. And that is our turn, so we ready up. We draw back up to 5. So we are getting 3 encounter cards next turn. That's, well, this villain phase, so that's not good. So we have combat training, prestige advantage, self-propelled glide, heroic intuition, and venom blast. So there's a good possibility to do a lot of damage next turn. It may mean that we don't get any of the heroes for hire, but that it is what it is. Let's see, we add 1 threat here. I'll just take the 1 damage on Spider Woman. Well, we have tough, so we just remove the tough. Taskmaster attacks, Spider Girl will defend. 3 plus 2, so 5. Spider Girl is defeated. And we get the encounter cards. First one is Hydra Hunter. Second one is Mimicry. When revealed, hero discards the top 5 cards of your deck. If an attack card was discarded this way, Taskmaster attacks you. Okay. No attack. So we got unluckily one attack card. So Taskmaster attacks me, but I won't defend. I'll take 4 damage. And the next card is the villain attacks you. If they have a weapon attachment, this card gains search. So now we have to defend. So we have to take 1 damage and we get 1 damage and search, advance. Okay, so we just lost by fretting out. Well, goddammit. Well, that was a chain of unlucky events, because next turn we could have dealt 5 damage, and if we would have been ready, we played 1, then we play... Yeah, we would have had 4 attack. We could have pressed the advantage and readied. So we would have had lethal, but yeah, it is what it is. I'll just reset the scenario and we'll try again, so I'll be right back. Okay, so let's try this again. We were pretty close last time, so hopefully we can defeat the Taskmaster this time. Let's draw our opening hand of 6 cards. So we get self-propelled glide, heroic intuition, pheromones, venom blast, piercing strike, and energy. I think we don't need piercing strike. We probably don't need venom blast. Let's see. I think we are playing pheromones. It will slow down Taskmaster quite a bit. And we could play Heroic Intuition just to get our threat removal up fast. I think I'll do that, so I'll just mulligan the... Yeah, let's mulligan the Venom Blast and see if we get something good. Well, we didn't. Okay. I think we'll change it that we'll play both of those. That seems good. So we'll check how much. Yeah, well, we're taking 1 damage when we flip, so we flip and we'll take 1 damage from the first response of Taskmaster. Then I will play pheromones. So we'll stun and confuse an enemy, and it's Taskmaster. We'll get 1 boost here, and I will dwarf for 2. We remove this. We'll search for a Hydra minion, and we'll get the Hydra regular. We add 1 here. Next we will play self-propelled glide. We ready, we'll defeat the regular. We do it again. and we'll hit Taskmaster for 3 damage, because we have plus 1, plus 2, so we have 3 attack, and that is our turn. I'll back up a bit. I think to be on the safe side, we'll just remove the threat from here for the last activation for Spider-Woman. We drop back up to 5. And we get another self-propelled glide. Interrogation room. Contaminant immunity. Press the advantage and Venom Blast. So next turn we can deal some damage. We'll go to the villain phase. We add one threat here. And I'll just add the threat. We'll get an encounter card. We remove the stun. We get a Hydra Soldier. And that's the villain phase. So let's go to the next hero phase. Okay. This turn, I'll think. I will do it this way, that I'll play down interrogation room with the self-propelled glide, and we'll get one here. Then we will use press the advantage and contaminant immunity to play Venom Blast. I will defeat the Hydra Soldier. We'll remove one threat from here. And we have an attack of 4. So we'll attack for 4. And I think I'll leap. So Taskmaster is not scheming, so we'll just see what card. So it would have been a gang up, so it is a gang up, so it can search, so it doesn't matter. We ready up. We draw back up to 6. We get another pheromones. Finesse, piercing strike, skilled investigator, types 2, and heroic intuition. The villain phase starts, we add a threat here, Taskmaster is confused, so it doesn't seem, and get gang up, which will search, and we get weapon master. The villain schemes, no weapon upgrade, so 1 plus 1, so 2 threat on the main scheme. So that is the villain phase, and let's move to the hero phase. Okay, let's see. We are taking 1 damage. And we go to hero mode. I'll use the heroic intuition and one of the skilled investigators to lay down finesse. I will flip. We'll take 1 damage. I'll use the finesse and piercing strike to play pheromones. And I'll also play the skilled investigator. So Taskmaster is again stunned and confused, and we will thwart for 3. And we'll ready up. We draw back up to 5. We get clear the area, times 3, interrogation room, and press the advantage, so, okay. Now we go to the villain phase. This turn we'll just add the threat here. Taskmaster tries to attack, is stunned, and counter guard is Taskmaster shield. Taskmaster gains retaliate 1, heroic action, exhaust your hero, and spend mental and a physical resource to remove. I don't have a physical resource, unfortunately, so I can't remove it. So it is what it is. We'll just have to focus on thwarting next turn. So let's go to the next hero phase. We'll play clear the area, bit clear the area. So we remove two. Get on here. We'll play clear the area with finesse. Remove that. Then we will press the advantage. So we deal 2 damage. And we'll take 1 from retaliate. And I'll just attack. So I'm hitting for 4 damage. We'll take 1 from retaliate. And that is our turn. We ready up. We get strength. Jessica's apartment, press the advantage, contaminant immunity, and tech team. Okay. Let's add a threat here and add a threat from the force response. Taskmaster attacks. I won't defend. We are taking 2 plus 0, so we'll take 2 damage. This is fine. Encounter card is. So we get the captured by Hydra finally. So add an acceleration token. Also one of these ally cards, so we shuffle them up. We get one at random, just get that one. So when we defeat this scheme, we get that hero, that ally card in hand, so we'll have to try and do that sometime in the future. But that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. This turn I think I'll exhaust Spider-Woman and use press the advantage and Jessica Drew's apartment to play to remove the Taskmaster shield. Then I will play the contaminant immunity. We heal 3 damage. We get 3 health and tough. And I'll just keep this in hand. We'll ready up. We get another tag team, Finesse, Genius, and Spider-Man. I think we could play Spider-Man next turn too. Yeah, that's actually a good idea. Okay, we'll add one threat here. We'll just add the second threat. Taskmaster attacks, I won't defend. Taskmaster hits for 4 damage, we'll remove the tough. Encounter card is another captured by Hydra. Okay, so we really need to start removing those one way or the other. And we get another ally. That one. And that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay. Let's see. We are playing Spider-Man. I'll use this to play an aspect card, so we need 4 more. Actually, let's back up a bit. I'll use the genius to play finesse. Then, do I have enough? I don't have enough. Like that. Okay, so we'll just do it this way. So keep the finesse in hand. I'll use these. So 4, 5. We get to remove 3 threat from a scheme. And Spider-Man will dwarf for 2. We'll remove this. And this gets removed from the game, so it doesn't go into the discard, and we'll get Electra in hand. And after you play Electra from your hand, spend a physical resource, deal 3 damage to an enemy. I think I'll just play it. And so actually we have one here. So I think we are not getting an extra card yet. So I will thwart for 2 here. And Electra will hit Taskmaster to phase 2. And we'll flip to Alter Ego. Oh yeah, I forgot to add one because of the acceleration token bastion, but I'll correct that now. So Electra hits for 3 damage, takes consequential, and we get an encounter card. And Taskmaster has 16 health. And that is our turn. We'll keep the finesse in hand. We'll get a skilled investigator. Oh yeah, we actually drew one card. I forgot about it. So we have Inconspicuous, times 2 combat training, Captain Marvel, and finesse. So it's ready up. We go to the villain phase. We add 2 threat here. Just change that to a fiver. And Taskmaster is confused. We get an encounter card. It is the first one is photographic reflexes attached to Taskmaster. When a player attacks Taskmaster, prevent all damage that would be dealt to Taskmaster and deal an equal amount of damage to that player's identity instead. Then discard photographic reflexes. Max once per attack. Okay, so we got 2 of these. So we put them there. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see. I think we can remove the other captured by Hydra to get another ally. So we'll check. So we are not taking any damage when we go to hero mode. That is fine. We'll just flip. So we don't get any. So we just discard, so it's not a boost card. So we don't trigger the boost effect. We'll play. Let's see. I'll use the skilled investigator and Captain Marvel to play finesse. Use finesse to play inconspicuous. We remove 3 threat from here. And then we'll play another inconspicuous. And we remove 2 from here and 1 from here. So this gets removed from the game. And we get Shang-Chi. So Shang-Chi is a 2-2 and 3 health ally. After you play Shang-Chi from your hand, spend an energy resource, stun an enemy. Well, just play him. Oh yeah, and we get one card. And I'll spend the energy resource because I had the card when I played Sanji. So we'll stun Taskmaster. And I'll I have to think. I'll hit Sanji with two the Taskmaster, so I'll remove one of these. I'll reflect the damage to Spider Woman. Then Spider-Man hits Taskmaster, so we remove this other one. And we'll take two. And then Spider-Woman hits for 3 damage. And Electra hits for 3 damage. And we'll ready up. And we draw back up to 5. So we have 2 comp trainings, 2 skilled investigators, and press the advantage in hand. We go to the villain phase, we add 1 threat here, and we'll add another threat here. And Taskmaster is stunned. Encounter cards are, first one is Hydra Hunter, doesn't do anything right now, and Assault, and we'll have to think about this. Electra will hit only once, so I'll defend with Electra. Okay, so Taskmaster hits for 3 damage, and that is the villain phase. So let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, we'll play combat training. So we get one here, and now we have an attack of 4. So I think we just have enough to defeat Taskmaster. Just checking, this Hydra Hunter doesn't have a guard. Yeah. Okay, so we'll use skilled investigator times 2 to play press the advantage. We'll deal 2 damage to Taskmaster. Then we'll attack for 4. And we'll attack for 4 with these guys, defeating Taskmaster. Okay. So that went better than the first one. And also we got 2 guys rescued. So let's check. Each player who rescued one or more allies from the Taskmaster encounter set adds those allies to their deck and records their names in the campaign log. So we got Shang-Chi and Elektra added into our deck. And that was Taskmaster on standard difficulty. Next, we will be playing against Zola. So that game is right after this one in the same video. And I'll just have to set up Zola and we can start playing against him. So I'll be right back. Okay, so after Taskmaster we face Zola. And we added a couple of new allies into our deck after defeating Taskmaster. So we have some campaign specific allies in our deck. In the setup for Zola, we had to put Captain Marvel in the Hydra prison, and because Captain Marvel costs 4 resources, we have 5 threat on the site scheme. We also have an ultimate bio servant in play, and it comes in play with toughness. So let's see how we can deal with Zola. So I've already shuffled the deck, so let's just get started and draw our opening hand. So we get contaminant immunity, pheromones, combat training, energy, venom blast, and finesse. Okay, let's use Jessica Drew's ability. Check the first card. So the first card is a one boost upgrade, so one boost card. So I think that's fine, but I think we might be playing pheromones. So let's see it again. So it's a tech upgrade. Attach to the minion with the most remaining hit points without any copy of defensive broken. If you cannot discard, gain search. So I think it's getting a search because we are possibly defeating the minion. Let's see if we can do that. I would like to get the finesse in play. Then we can attack to remove the tough and venom blast. So I think I'll keep the pheromones in hand. I'll just keep this hand. It looks like good enough. So we'll flip. I'll play finesse with energy. Let's see. Yeah, so I'll just remove the tough. Then I will venom blast the bio servant. And we'll get one counter here. I'll keep the pheromones in hand. I think we'll play that next turn. That is our turn. We draw back up to 5. So we have Inconspicuous, Jessica Drew's apartment, Heroic Intuition, Self-Propelled Glide, and Pheromones. So we add a threat here, and there's a forced response after resolving the step 1 of the villain phase. Place one test counter here. I'll just use these as test counters. When there are 3 or more test counters here, discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until a minion is discarded. Put that minion into play, engage with the first player, and remove 3 test counters from the scheme. Okay, so I think we will be seeing a lot of minions in this scenario. So, Zola will attack, I won't defend. It's 1 plus 1, so we get 2 damage. And the encounter card is Neurological Implants, so it's a tech upgrade. Attach the minion with the most remaining hit points without any copy of Neurological Implants attached. If you cannot discard, gain search. So I'm seeing a pattern or theme here, so we are getting a lot of minions and techs that get attached to them. But if we cannot, we gain search. Well, this gain search again. And we get Zola's Mute. So when we discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until a tech attachment is discarded, attach that to Zola's Mutate. So let's start discarding. We get Defensive Programming. Attach the minion with the most remaining hit points without any copy of defense programming attached. Attached minion gets plus 2 hit points and gains guard. So now we need to defeat Zola's Mute before we can hit Zola. And Mute has 7 hit points, so quite a tough minion to deal with. And that is the first turn. Let's go to the next hero phase. Let's see how we deal with this Zola's Mute. I don't think we have that much to do this turn. So I think I'll start removing, or at, I'll remove the Hydra prison this turn, so I'll be inconspicuous. We'll remove three threat from there. And do I want to play pheromones this turn? I think I do. So we'll just remove this, and the Hydra prison, when it's defeated, remove this scheme from the game and return each ally beneath it to its owner's hand. So we remove that and we'll get Captain Marvel. We could actually play Captain Marvel this turn. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So we'll play Captain Marvel. Because I'm not really getting any benefit from the card, I won't attack with Captain Marvel. I'll just flip. Let's check the card. So it's one boost, so Zola is scheming for three. So we're getting 4, 2, 5, 6. So we're advancing this. I think we want to avoid that, so I'll have to thwart with Captain Marvel to remove one threat from this main scheme. And we'll draw a card. It's the interrogation room. Well, that's not really helpful. And let's ready up. We'll draw back up to 6. Then we go to the villain phase. We add one threat here. We add one test counter here. Zola will scheme for 2 plus 1, so 3. And the Zola's mute will scheme for 1. So we are at 5 and we don't advance yet. And the encounter card is it's Vibranium Armor. That's the villain. After the villain takes damage, give it tough status. Hero action, exhaust your hero and spend 2 physical resources. Discard this card, so I think we'll have to get that removed some way. And yeah, let's look. We had got Piercing Strike, Tag Team, Skilled Investigator, Interrogation Room, Shang-Chi, which is the new campaign-specific ally, and Interrogation Room. So let's see what we can do next turn. So that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. I'll use Jessica Drew's ability to check the top card again. We get Mind Ray. So it will be a boost card, which is good because this boost card is really nasty. Treachery is really nasty. So we need 2 physical resources to remove the... Yeah. I think we don't need Shang-Chi's ability to stun an enemy. So we'll just play Shang-Chi. We'll flip. We need 7, we have 4. Yeah, this is removed. We have Piercing Strike, but that's our one of our... I think we'll just ignore the Vibranium Armor this turn. We'll focus on dealing with this Zola's Mute. Because it has Guard, we have to deal with that. So I'll use Finesse, and actually I'll use Finesse to play Interrogation Room down. We get 1 here. So now we have a 3 attack with Spider-Woman. So we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And that's enough to deal with the Zola's Mute. So first thing, I'll hit Zola's Mute with the Captain Marvel. And we'll draw a card. Okay. Just defeat it. Actually, let's count this. Can I boost? Can I boost? Good play, tag team. Okay. I'll play tag team down. I'll use the other interrogation room, skilled investigator, and the other tag team. So we boost ourselves up by one more. So now we can hit with Spider-Woman. We are hitting with 4 damage, and we are hitting the Zola's Mute. I think I'll keep the piercing strike in hand. I'll use the tag team to finish off this Zola's Mute. And we'll trigger interrogation room. We remove one threat from here. And Shang-Chi will actually remove 2 more threats from there. I think that's the best play for this turn. Let's ready up. We draw back up to 5. We have skilled investigator, heroic intuition, clear the area times 2 and piercing strike. So let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat here. We also add the third test counter here. So we remove 3 test counters and we discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until a minion is discarded. So we get another Zola's Mute, which will trigger that we search for tech upgrade. Well, there are no tech upgrades anywhere inside. This is looking bad for us because we are running out of this deck quite fast and getting an acceleration token. But yeah, we get the pain inhibitors. So the attached minion gets plus 2 hit points and gains retaliate 1. So again, this Zola's Mute has 7 hit points and now it has retaliate. So not looking nice. So Zola attacks, I think I will defend with Captain Marvel. No, I'll just take it with Spider-Woman. I won't defend. It's 1 plus 1, so we take 2 damage. And the Zola's Mute attacks, I'll take it with Spider-Woman again. Take 2 damage. And we get an encounter card, and it is Zola's Experiment. Forced response: after a minion enters play, attach the top tech attachment in the encounter discard pile to that minion. So it will add an acceleration token, and it has 3 threat on it. So I'm pretty sure we need to remove that as fast as possible. But yeah, that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Let's see. Well, these are removed. I think we need to remove Zola's Mute again. But first, I'll Yeah, I think I'll save the clear the area until the end, so that we can first use interrogation room to remove one threat from there, then play clear the area and draw a card. So first I'll play skilled investigator, and then I will piercing strike. I'll use clear the area and heroic intuition to play the clear piercing strike. So we get one here, we'll deal 3 damage here, we'll take one from retaliate. So now I'm hitting with 4 with Spider Woman, because 1, 2, 3, 4, so I'll just hit Zola's Mute. I'll take one from retaliate, but we will defeat it. And we can trigger interrogation room, then we can play clear the area with finesse. We'll get rid of this. And also we draw a card from the clear the area, and we draw a card from skilled investigator. Okay, so we get genius and piercing strike. Then I think Captain Marvel will thwart for 2. We draw a card, and Captain Marvel is discarded, and we don't have two. Oh yeah, this is played. We really need to remove that vibranium armor, but we don't have things to remove it with. So I think I'm using the piercing strike to clear the area. To remove this, we'll draw another card. Press the advantage. I think I will just flip and do nothing else. We don't want to give the tough statuses to Zola. Also, Zola has retaliate, so we don't want to take excess amount of damage, and Shang-Chi will just chill. So let's check the top card. We are getting a boost, Shadows of the Past as a boost card, so that's fine. We ready up. We draw back up to 6. We have self-propelled glide, pheromones, piercing strike, another finesse, press the advantage, and genius. So next turn we can remove the vibranium armor. And yeah, let's see. We can also play finesse and play self-propelled glide. Okay, this looks like a decent turn, next turn. So we go to the villain phase, we add one threat on the main scheme and one test counter. Zola schemes for 2+2, so we are at 5. And counter card is technological enhancements. Insight 1. When revealed, place one test counter on the main scheme. And so we'll add one threat here, so that's a bummer. And we'll also add one test counter here. And now I can't remember, because I'm paying too much Arkham Horror, that if we I think we advance in any step if we reach the threshold for the threat in on a scheme. So I'll just play test that we advance. So the Mad Doctor. When revealed, each player searches the encounter deck and discards a minion and reveals it, shuffle the encounter deck. And we have the Mad Doctor 2B. So force response after resolving step 1 of the villain phase, place one test counter here. So it's the same as before, but if we complete this, we will lose. So, and that comes into play with one threat already. So I think I'll just search for a minion from here and put it into play. So I'll take the Berserker Mutate, because it's an easy minion to defeat, and it has quick strike, but we are in alter ego, so it won't hit us. And that is the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, let's see. So first thing, we remove that. We will just heal. And then we will flip. Then I'll play the other finesse. I'll play self-propelled glide with press the advantage to ready. I will spend 2 physical resources and exhaust Spider-Woman to get rid of this one. Then we need to defeat the Berserk Mutate, so Shang-Chi will hit it for 2. And tag team will remove it and will trigger interrogation room. We'll remove one threat from here. And that is the our turn. We have nothing to play with Finesse, which is a bummer, but it is what it is. We're ready. We draw back up to 5. We get press the advantage, Venom Blast, Spider-Man, Combat Training, and Electra. So I think next turn we'll try to start hitting the Zola as much as possible and try to get him to phase 2 and finally defeat him sometime in the future. But let's see what happens in the villain phase. So I will go to the villain phase. We add one threat here. We'll add one counter here, which will cause us to search for a minion. Now we manage to fail to find a minion, so we stop as the encounter deck unfolds. So we just shuffle and add an acceleration token. So we locked out there. The Zola will attack. I think I'll defend with Shang-Chi. And I think we can take Zola's hit because it's only an attack 1 plus the boost card. So yeah, I'll take it with Spider-Woman. Well, I won't defend, so we get 1 boost icon, so we take 2 damage, which is fine. Encounter card is uncertain loyalties. You may flip to alter ego form. Exhaust Jessica Drew, remove uncertain loyalties from the game. Place 3 threat on the main scheme. Discard this obligation. I'll just discard it and add the 3 threat, because we are holding Spider-Man in our hand, so we're probably playing him and removing a ton of threat. So that is totally fine. So That is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. In order for us to play Spider-Man, we can use both of the finesse cards and each other card from our hand. Then we can also play Electro. I think I'll do that. So first thing, I will play Spider-Man. I'll use Combat Training, Venom Blast, and press the advantage to play Spider-Man. And when after you play Spider-Man from your hand, remove 3 threat per player from a side. It's a side scheme. Oh well, we can to war with Spider-Man. Really struggling with some of the new cards because I'm always forgetting it's either a side scheme or any scheme. But that's fine, we'll get one here. We'll also play Electra. And I think Spider-Woman will thwart for 2. Spider-Man will thwart for 2. Electra will hit for 3. Take 1 retaliate. And Shang-Chi will hit for 2. Get defeated. So we are starting to get damage into Zola. I want to use the tag team this turn. I'll save it if we have to deal with a minion. So I'll ready up. Draw back up 5. We get strength, Spider-Girl, skilled investigator, press the advantage, and contaminant immunity. Okay, we'll go to the villain phase. We'll add 2 threat on the main scheme and 1 test counter. Zola attacks for 1 plus. I'll just take it. I think this turn I will defend with Spider-Woman. So I have a defense of 2, so 1 plus 3. So good thing we at least got rid of some of the damage, so we'll take 2 damage. So we are down to 3 health. Encounter card is Mind Ray. Zola attacks you. You are stunned. I'll get stunned. But I think I will defend with Electra. Shuffle Zola's mute into the encounter deck, so Electra takes 1 damage and is defeated. Okay, well, I think I'm heading to heal next turn, probably. But we'll see. So that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. This turn, let's see what we can do. So I think I'll just remove the stun by playing press the advantage. But it won't trigger the retaliate because it's cancelled because of the stun, but we get to remove the stun. I'll use finesse. So we got 1 from that. We'll play contaminant immunity with the finesses. We'll get tough. And we also heal 3. And I think Spider-Man is thwarting for 2. I'll just play Spider-Girl. And we'll wait so we don't do anything else. Already up. Go back up to 5, we get an extra encounter card for next turn. We get inconspicuous, self-glide, clear the area, heroic intuition, and interrogation room, so not gonna get a bunch of boosts for Spider-Woman next turn, but we'll see. We go to the villain phase, we add two threat here. Zola attacks, I'll take it with Spider-Woman. Zola hits for 1 plus 2, so we'll just remove the tough. Encounter card. Our first one is Zola's mute, so we discard until we take upgrade. So it gains plus 2 hit points and guard. So we definitely need to remove that guy next turn. The other one is attached to the minion with most remaining hit points without any copy of the neurological implants. So you get plus 2 hit points and plus 2 scheme and plus 2 attack. Okay, so we'll definitely need to beat up this 9 health Zola's mute next turn somehow. Okay, so that is the villain phase. Oh yeah, we should have added one here. So that's the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. So let's see. I think I'm using one of the finesses to play clear the area. Remove these two. We'll draw a card. We get Sanchi. Nice. That helps us to clear off the Zola's mute. So let's count. We also got one here. So we can hit two times with Spider-Woman because we have the self-propelled glide. We are hitting 3 damage per hit, which is quite nice. Also, we could use this Shang-Chi to stun Zola, which will help. So let's see. I'll just hit for 3 damage here. I will play self heroic. Actually, I don't think the stun is. Well, it helps. I think I'll have to do that. But can I play the heroic intuition down? I think not. Yeah, I'm missing one resource to make that work. So I'll just use the interrogation room to play self-propelled glide to ready. I'll hit for another 3 damage. So we still need 3 damage to defeat that. I'll use an energy resource when I play Shang-Chi to stun Zola. And I'll hit the mute with Zola and Spider with Shang-Chi and Spider-Girl. So it gets defeated. Just checking, it didn't have retaliate or anything like that, so we get rid of it. We don't have any threat to remove, so we can't trigger interrogation room. But yeah, I think Spider-Man will just... I won't hit with Spider-Man because their retaliate would defeat Spider-Man, and he's more valuable on the table at the moment, so ready up. I'll discard the heroic intuition. We draw back up to 5. We get self-propelled glide, press the advantage, Captain Marvel, strength, attack team. So I think we will be playing Captain Marvel next turn, but we'll go to the villain phase. We add two threat here, we add another test counter and remove them. And we'll discard cards until we hit the minion. So we get ultimate bio servant, so it comes into play with tough. And there's no enhancement on it, so it doesn't get any plus attack. Okay, well, that's that, and then we get Zola's attack, which is stopped by the stun. Then we get encounter card, and it is advanced, so Zola schemes. Zola schemes for give the villain a tough status card. Okay, so we just keep Zola tough, and Zola schemes for two. And that's the villain phase, so let's go to the next hero phase. So, I think we could basically ignore the bio servant and just try to hit Zola. Oh yeah, I should be readied. This is removed. Let's see. I think Spider-Girl will just remove Tough from Zola. Unfortunately, we don't have a piercing strike. That would have helped immensely this turn. So, let's play another tag team down. I'll use both of the finesses for it. And let's backtrack a bit. We'll first play Captain Marvel. So that we can draw a card with Captain Marvel. So Captain Marvel hits Zola for two and takes a retaliate, so two damage there. We draw a card, we gain combat training. Now we use the finesses and combat training to play tag team. So now the math works. So now we get this. We'll hit Zola with... Actually, Spider-Man will thwart for two. Spider-Woman will hit Zola for three damage. And Shang-Chi will hit Zola for... Actually, no. We'll use the tag team we just played to deal two damage. We'll advance to phase two. So, when revealed, search the encounter deck and discover for the test subject, side scheme, and reveal it. So we have one in the discard, we'll put it into play. It comes into play with two. And now we can use Shang-Chi to thwart that away. When defeated, the first player discards cards from the top of the encounter deck until they discard a minion. Reveal that minion. So we get another minion. We get the Berserk Mutate, which has quick strike, so it hits for two right away. And Zola has 14 hit points. So I think I'll just spend the other... Well, I'm gonna save it. can do a bigger turn some other turn. So I think this turn I will go to Alter Ego. Let's see how much Zola will scheme. So only for two. And yeah, we defeated a side scheme, so we could have triggered skill to investigator, but yeah, let's just check. So we get genius, we'll definitely keep it. We don't have anything to play with it. We ready up. Just remove that and we draw back up to six. We have Inconspicuous Venom Blast, Jessica Drew's apartment, clear the area, self-propelled glide, and genius, so we can do a big turn next turn, hitting with Spider Woman three times without getting defeated. And let's quickly count how much we can do next turn. Well, I'll count it after the villain phase, so. So the villain phase starts, we have two threat here, Zola schemes, so we just shuffle this guy back into the decks and add two here. And that guy schemes for one. This guy doesn't scheme. We're nearly threaded out. Okay, so the encounter card for this turn is under attack. I think I'll have to put the threat here. So, because we can't take the damage. Yeah, so that's the villain phase. Let's see if we can defeat Zola next turn. So let's go to the hero phase. Okay, so let's count quickly. We have 4 damage here. And 6 damage here, so 10 plus we can just Venom Blast, so we have enough to defeat Zola. So let's just ignore everything else and flip to Spider Woman. I will use both of the tag teams to deal 4. Then Shang-Chi, Captain Marvel draws us a card, Spider-Man all get defeated, but all deal a total of 6 damage. So Zola has only 4 damage remaining. Then we'll just Venom Blast, playing both of the playing it with both of the finesses and deal 5 damage, so we managed to defeat Zola just in the nick of time before the main scheme would have advanced. So, oh yeah, there should be one counter here which we've got, but it doesn't matter. So that was Zola. I think Zola is a really interesting and different kind of encounter or scenario. Compared to the previous ones, it reminds me a bit of the mutagen formula, which has a lot of minions specific for that scenario. This also has these mutes and Yayo servants and very interesting interactions with the tech guards. So I really like this scenario. I'm definitely gonna try it out with a souped up hero in expert mode later to see how it goes, but on standard with the pre-built Spider-Woman deck, this was a good challenge, really tough, and went to where we nearly lost at the end, but we managed to survive. So that is the Rise of Red Skull Zola scenario. So next time we will be playing against the man himself, Red Skull, and that will be in a separate video, so look forward to that, and thanks for watching, and until next time.